is a sleep and sanity saver for parents and babies everywhere.
When our daughter, Charlotte, was a newborn, we practiced the swaddle technique, where we wrapped her up like a little burrito, and the tight and cozy fit helped her sleep through the night. This is our son, Maverick. He's all snug in a swaddle, and then all of a sudden, like most babies, eventually, they break out. And they start scratching their face, waking themselves up, and that's never good for the baby or the parent. Well, our daughter, as she got older, began waking up every 15 minutes. We were exhausted. We knew that we had to do something to transition off the swaddle.
Out of desperation and exhaustion, I sat down on my little sewing machine and the fabulous Zipadee-Zip was born. Like a swaddle, it mimics the cozy enclosed environment of the womb, but it also allows a baby to push up and roll over and wiggle around safely and freely. I'll show you a little bit how it works. So this is our little son, Maverick again, sleeping in a Zipadee-Zip. And he startles. And as you can see, because of the slight resistance in the arms, he's able to put himself back to sleep without my help.
Aww.
So when our daughter tried the Zipadee-Zip the first time, she slept 12 hours, which means we slept 12 hours that night.
So what makes the baby fall asleep in this? Because he's not tight.
No, I can tell you a little bit of science behind it. So a baby, when they're stuck in the womb for a really long time, they're in that little tiny ball, right? And so when they are out of the womb, all of a sudden there's this freedom and they have something called a Moro reflex.
A what?
A Moro reflex, it's a startle reflex. So that when a baby puts their arms out, they kind of feel like they're falling until they jolt. And like you saw right there. And so they need to feel their edges. And if they're able to feel their edges, then they're able to fall back asleep a lot more efficiently.
So it's a womb-like protective state.
Exactly.